In previous videos, we saw two points of view towards solving a system of linear equations. One views the process as gradually reducing the system to smaller ones, until we get down to either one variable or one equation. The other views the process as transforming Ax equal to b to an equivalent system Rx equal to d, where R is in reduced row echelon form. In this video, we are going to combine the ideas from these two views and describe a procedure that can be implemented easily. This procedure is usually called Gaussian elimination. The overall idea is this. Given the system Ax equal to b, we first form the matrix A and B, and we apply elementary row operations in a systematic manner until we get down to the matrix Rd, where R is in reduced row echelon form. But the question is, what is this systematic manner? We'll illustrate this with an example, and before we proceed, let's recall what elementary row operations are. The first operation you can perform is, you can replace a row, say row I, with a constant multiple of the same row, where the constant is non-zero. The second operation is, you can replace row I with a non-zero multiple of row j, where j is not the same as I, added to row I. And the third operation is, we can exchange row I and row j, where I is not equal to j. So these are the elementary row operations. And using these operations, you can transform a matrix into reduced row echelon form. Let's work through an example. Let A be the following matrix, and B be 3, 1, 1. So the augmented matrix will look like this. Very often, people put a vertical dotted line between the coefficient matrix and the right-hand side tuple. Remember that we want to bring the matrix consisting of the first columns to reduce row echelon form. And towards that goal, we're going to do the following. We'll take minus 2 times first row and add it to the second row. And that will make the first entry in the second row 0. And we'll add row 1 to row 3 to do the same. So this is 2 times row 1. And the result is this. As you can see, this is now one step closer to what we want to get at the end. Notice that in the third row, the leftmost non-zero entry is left of the leftmost non-zero entry in the second row. And in this case, what we want to do is, we're going to swap the two rows. So we're going to interchange row 2 and row 3. And now if you look at row 2, the leftmost non-zero entry is not a 1. So I'm going to multiply row 2 by 1/2. Alright, now if I look at the leftmost non-zero entry in row 3, it's not 1. So I'm going to multiply row 3 by minus 1 over 4. Now this matrix is in row echelon form. So what we need to do next is, for each leading one, we need to make sure that the other entries in the same column are all 0. So for example, I need to make sure that this entry here becomes 0 and this entry here becomes 0. And I'm going to do that by adding minus 2 times row 3 to row 1 and add minus row 3 to row 2. And now to finish up, I'm going to add row 2 to row 1. If you look at this matrix, this is precisely the form that we want. And here, x1, x2, and x3 are the basic variables. There's no zero row in the left-hand side. So we can obtain a solution by setting x4 to 0, and that gives x equal 5 over 4, 3 over 4, 5 over 4, and 0. And you can easily check that this is indeed the solution, and there are many more. Now to tie things up, we should write down the procedure for the general case more formally. But we won't do it here, because the pseudocode can be found easily on the internet. Some links are provided in the description of this video. We'll come back to Gaussian elimination in a future video, where we'll interpret each of the elementary row operations as a matrix multiplication.